for the cheapest, fastest, most reliable muck coins in the market. Check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Snip of the Magic, as always. Got some plays for you guys today out of my Raiders offensive ebook. I haven't put out a ton of plays from them lately, but since the November patch came out, I had to go through all my old books and update them with a ton of new plays. And the play I'm going to show you guys today probably is the glitchiest one. It was one of the better plays pre-patch, but to me, it's like one of the meta one-play touchdowns post-patch. I mean, you can score against any single defense in the game with one or two adjustments, depending on what you're looking at. And it also has a ton of great, you know, supporting plays, which I'm not sure if I'm going to show in today's video or if I'm just going to have my ebooks and on my Patreon. I'm going to join that community tab, depending on how long the video goes. But as always, if you guys want to see a full breakdown of this offense or more Raiders stuff, let me know in the comment section. Hit the like button. Other than that, let's go and get right into the formation. The formation itself is the Gun Bunch TE. The play itself that I'm going to be focused on most of the time when it comes to this particular video is going to be the PA boot over. Like I said, this is one of the meta plays pre-patch, but to me, post-patch is even better. I mean, there's not a ton of great concepts when it comes to bombing up cover three right now, but this particular play, you can score against just about any single defense in the game. I really find the best way to run this would be the inside switch, the inside zone, the halfback off tackle, and the PA boot over. Those would be the four plays that I like to run the most. So I'm going to go ahead and pick that play first. Then on the defensive side, we usually, like I said, I'm focusing on cover three, but we're going to start off with cover two. Now, as always, this video is brought to you by my coin sponsor, AOEAH.com. If you guys want to get your Mutt team up and support this channel at the same time, all you have to do is check them out. Link in the description below and use discount code MONEY to get 3% off what's always guaranteed to be the cheapest coins on the market. Now, as far as this play goes, pre-patch, all I ever really did was put the A route on a streak. Now you can see they messed up the last patch, I think the October patch, they messed up how this streak works, but this is still a good play. I mean, you can run it like this and you can see these crossing receivers, you could still get like really nice gains. Typically that receiver is going to be your biggest play, but ultimately why do that when you can score one play touchdown? You can do this. Like I said, this is something where I still highly recommend it, but I could score a one play touchdown against just about any single defense in the game now just by putting this A route on a fade. The cover three setup is going to be different, and a couple of there'll be different setups with a couple of different plays, but ultimately this is the most prominent one. Now the only other thing I would say is you want to slide your protection to the right, but watch what happens with this cover three or cover two safety now because of this delay fade. You can see right here the safety just reacts way too harshly to that cover two or to that delay fade, which is something that I think they were trying to patch. The only thing they really fix when it comes to the delay fade is you don't no longer have any control over when it releases, but that didn't really solve the issue. Like, it still is really glitching when it comes to pulling safeties down, which is something that really didn't get fixed. So as long as that corner or that tight end doesn't get back quick enough, you can see how this guy can get right over the top against just about any safety in the game. They tried to pass the delay fade, but all they really did was make it release on its own timing, which it still, you know, has the same effect. It still pulls safeties down, which is why, as you can see right here, that safety is going to react to this, you know, the delay fade, and that's why I can get over the top of them with a fast enough receiver. Now that was a little bit closer than I would like. Like I said, it really depends. This can be a little bit hit or miss as far as when that safety or when that delay fade releases. Like right here, he didn't release at all. So you can see I'm gonna get much more separation, but it's something that can be an easy one play touchdown against any cover two. And that includes cover two man. So let's go and let's pick that. Gonna have the exact same effect. Although here, that guy, that rusher just came in straight away. And then you can see here, like I said, I just have to bomb it up over the top as we get a pretty tight window. Like I said, that's the thing. I mean, I'm going against the best safety in the game, but I'm gonna do that one more time. Like I said, I like to slide my protection. If he's on that delay fade and he gets out early like he does here, that's not necessarily good for me, but you can see it's still a very easy one play touchdown. It gets over the top. The number one safety in the game, Tyrann Mathieu, can't do nothing for it. Now against cover three, it's a little bit different. There's a little bit more of a setup to it. Now when it comes to cover three, it's a very different setup. I'd say cover three and cover one, you're gonna wanna do it this way. All you're gonna wanna do is put the Y route here on a fade. I'll slide my protection one more time. You're gonna see how these short routes pull this cornerback down and apart. And then you can see he's just gonna get right over the top for a very easy one play touchdown, although I had to throw that on the run. Delay fades have a little bit of an issue when it comes to pass pro. I could also block my running back. I don't really need him doing that, but I do like how it kind of pulls me in a direction, like in like a sprinting direction across, because I like to get out there anyway. And then you can see, like I said, very easy one play touchdown against cover three and also cover one man. Against cover one man, I'd run it the same way, but you don't really need to do anything against man coverage. You could just leave it as is. Man zero, cover one man, I would say they both have the same effect, but I like that streak pulling that safety back. And then you can see it just makes it a lot easier to get across the formation. So cover zero, cover one man, that'd be the same setup as cover three. Now, when it comes to a defense like cover four quarters, I don't think you need any adjustments at all. So ultimately, if somebody's running cover four quarters, you're just gonna, I mean, the Y route's right there already. I gotta take that Y route right away, but you can see the X route's gonna be a home run, one play touchdown. That's gonna be the easiest one. So if you can buy a little time, both of those routes are gonna be open against cover four quarters. Now, the only real difference is gonna be cover four. So cover four drop, let's go and let's pick that. Got to go to the dollar formation for that, but cover four drop contain is going to be a little bit different. The only real difference when it comes to cover four drop contain or cover four where it's not matching is you have to run it to the short side of the field. So I'm going to run from the hash mark to the short side, do the exact same setup as the cover three play, and you're going to see that for whatever reason, this just has a much more, you know, effective rate when it comes to beating the cover four cornerback. As you can see, you know, I just basically have to wait until he's parallel with that strong safety and then bullet and pass lead away. I said this here, you know, I'm waiting for this guy to basically go right for that strong safety. And then when I bullet and pass lead away, you can see, I mean, it looks like if he's going straight back, I have no play, but he's not. He's crossing his back. So the second I bullet and pass lead away, I just have to click on and sprint away for the throw, and you can see I'm always going to get separation. So I'm going to do that one more time. I can block my running back. I don't really need him doing that, but the play action, I do find like the play action is helpful. So I'm going to do that one more time. Like I said, just fade this Y route. Basically got to buy time. Wait for this X route here to cross. There you can see actually got past them, which sometimes will happen. I think the play action helps when it comes to bringing those cover four safeties in, because ultimately, typically cover four safeties play down. If I watch the replay here, he probably bit on that play action. So this is something where, like I said, you know, they don't typically go straight back like cover two safeties. So the play action helps a little bit. Now my second favorite pass play would definitely be the inside switch. This is something that you can run against just about anything. So we're gonna pick random nickel. Now I would say the best way to run this play is to motion this guy across and either put him on a streak to pull back coverage, depending on what zone coverage you're looking at, or a slant. That's really going to be your two best options. But I'll go ahead and I'll just do the streak most times, because this play here is really all about the running back. I like to throw to him, whether it's any zone coverage, he typically gets underneath it and is a good catch and run option. That's going to be something that you're going to have pretty much all game. You can also just put the Y route on a streak and basically just work this RB route. If you don't make any motions, this play here really plays off of the first play. The first play, your opponent's going to be worried about that most of the time, but that's really the play. I mean, once your opponent's focusing on the wrong issues on the left side, you can really take them underneath for a lot of easy catch and run gains to the running back and the tight end. Like I said, especially zone coverages when it comes to the running backs. If you have a fast enough running back, he can beat man coverages as well. The A route is also a very good option, especially if you have a good tight end, like right here. I mean, he's going to get outside what looks like a cover three zone. And I don't know, leave me out of the score here. I'm just making dudes miss. Like I said, you got a good enough tight end in this game, you can make big plays with the tight end throw as well. Got some good run plays here. We'll start off with the inside zone. This is going to be best against cover two. Pretty much any spread defensive look or any cover two man or zone where the safeties play back, you're going to have a lot of success just hitting with this inside zone. I mean, this is going to be an easy, 5 to 10 yards pretty much every single time, just as long as there's, I mean, especially when you have a spread defensive alignment like that. You see that guy, a defensive end is out wide. It's just going to be an easy, once again, an underneath play. You're going to basically be setting up the deep play with a lot of these shorter plays throughout the game. That's pretty much how you want to run this offense. And then your off tackle look will be best against things like cover threes and cover fours where the cornerbacks play outside. This here, once again, I mean, we want to try to run this play when, you know, that defensive end being out wide like that, not really 100% a fan of that, but you can see how there's going to be space out here. Against cover three and cover four where the cornerbacks play back, you have a good option to run outside. So I'll do that a few times. Like I said, anytime you got a cover three, anytime those cornerbacks play back, you can see how there's just nothing but space out here. And we're having, you know, explosive runs. I mean, you got three receivers blocking out here. Against zone coverage, typically there's going to be one or two defenders. You can see there's cornerback and it looks like a box safety, and that's it. Just as long as that defensive end gets sealed by that left tackle, you have a blocking advantage. You have a 3-on-2 blocking advantage. Another good, deep, complementary play, my personal favorite play, would be the stick. So we'll go and we'll flip that. We'll pick that play next. We're just going to go random nickel normal again. So all I'm going to do on this play is streak my Y route. My B route is going to be the read pretty much every single time. I'll also drag my A route and block my running back. The drag is going to be my zone or my man check down. But the B route here is going to get open against just about any zone coverage. You can see it. I guess we had a cover two. Gets wide open between the cornerback and the safety. But you're pretty much just going to be running this, just like this. Just basically, if it's a man, you're going to take your drag. But any zone coverage is always going to be the X route or the B route. So here it looks like we might have that man or that cover two once again. Just say you get a really big catch and run against cover two a lot of times if you don't have Tyrann Mathieu out there. But ultimately that's a huge cover two play and it'll work against pretty much any zone coverage because a lot of times, even if it's a cover three, it looks like we're getting another. I don't know if these are cover twos or what, but you can see we're getting a lot of big plays right up the seam there. Like I said, cover three, the cornerbacks will drop back. Cover four, the cornerbacks will drop back and give you that route pretty much every single time. And then you also have that flat, which is a good check down. Like I said, I don't know if I'm getting... I can't imagine I've been hit with three straight cover two plays, but you can see how easy this play is. So that's the vid. If you guys want to see more out of the Raiders playbook, hit the like button and let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. My shit out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below. Thank you.